हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू दिस लेक्चर. दिस इज द लेक्चर नंबर 10 इन दिस सीरीज. इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द लोड्स. लोड्स इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर और इम्पॉर्टेंट पैरामीटर विच वी हैव टू स्टडी एंड अंडरस्टैंड व्हाइल डिजाइनिंग एनी स्ट्रक्चर. The specifications about load have been given in clause number 19 of IS 456-2000 on page number 32. So as per the clause, the loads are which are acting on the structure can be classified as follows. The first and very important load is the dead load. Dead load is nothing but its self-weight or self-weight of the structure or structural components. So for calculation of these dead loads, as specified that, so to get the different values of dead load of structural components or materials, it is specified that we must use IS 875 part 1. Then second load is imposed load. It is also termed as live load. It is a load of components, persons who are not constant. Means that particular load is not constant on the structure. It is going to change within the time. That's why this load is also called as a live load. So as per the specifications, these live load values have been provided in IS 875 part 2. The third load, very important load, is wind load. It is a lateral type of load which is going to act on the structures whenever the wind intensity increases, or also it will be a very predominant type of load, particularly in case of high rise structures. For getting detailed information about these wind loads, it is recommended to use IS 875 part. Then the snow load. Snow load means whenever, wherever snowfall occurs, at that time that load is coming on the structural components, particularly the roofs, and it is again transferred to the columns, then to the foundation. So while designing all these components, we have to consider the snow load. So for this consideration of snow load, it is recommended to use IS 875 part 4. It is to be noted that the snow load is to be considered in the regions wherever snowfall is possible. In the rest of the country, it is not required to consider the snow load. Then the fifth load, and which is very important load, is the earthquake forces, or may be also termed as seismic forces. So for seismic forces or earthquake forces evaluation, one separate code has been provided, which is IS 1893 part 1, which is recently revised in 2016. And apart from all these loads, there are some other loads, just like the loads coming from the traction, particularly in the industrial buildings, loads which may be exerted on the structural components or structures during the erection of those structures, just like during the construction of the building, we are using the equipments like cranes just for lifting the materials from one place to other place. At that time, some loads are going to add, or some loads are going to act on the structures, which we normally not considered in the dead load, live load, wind load, etc. So such kind of forces, such kind of loads are to be considered as a miscellaneous forces. So for this, we have to refer as 875 part 5. So this is the clause number 19, which specifies the loads and the forces which we have to consider whenever we are going to design the buildings or structures. Particularly in this code or in these provisions, as per clause number 19.5, the values or the effects of shrinkage, creep and temperature is to be considered in which situation or in which situation we have to neglect it. That specifications have been given, and these values or the calculations are also included in the miscellaneous forces as per the IS 875 part 5. Along with this, some clauses are also mentioned in IS 456 2000, just like the clause number 6.2.4, 6.2.5 and 6.2.6, which will give you some conditions wherever the effects of shrinkage, creep, temperature are to be considered as a materially in the safety and serviceability conditions of the structure. The main load which is going to act on the structure at all the time is the dead load. Just as I told you, that dead load is nothing but the self-weight of the structure or self-weight of the components. Hence, the dead load shall be calculated on the basis of unit weights, and which shall be established taking into consideration the materials specified for the construction. Means that whatever material we are going to use, all those materials are having some unit, some specific weights. So those weights we have to consider for the calculation of the total load. Hence, alternatively, the dead load may be calculated on the basis of unit weight of materials given in IS 875 part 1. So just like the unit weight is given in the IS 875 part 1, but sometimes it may be possible that the unit weight are needed to be calculated because of addition of some other materials. Just like in concrete, we may add some additional materials like fly ash or other things. So in that case, there may be possibilities of change in the unit weight, so that we have to confirm once when we are going to consider such kind of experimentation work. Unless that more accurate calculations are warranted or required, the unit weight of plain concrete and reinforced concrete made with the normal river sand and gravel or crushed natural stone aggregate, just like basalt aggregates, may be taken as 24 kN per meter cube for the plain cement concrete and 25 kN per meter cube for reinforced cement concrete. The unit weight of important building materials used by the designers are as follows in this table. For the plain cement concrete, it is 24 kN per meter cube. For reinforced cement concrete, it is 25 kN per meter cube. These two values we are going to use frequently in further lectures or in further part of this course. So just note down this all table. The brick masonry with cement plaster, the unit weight may be considered as 20 kN per meter cube, and the brick masonry without plaster, it is considered as 18 kN per meter cube. The unit weight of AC sheets, that is asbestos cement sheet, which is normally used for the roofing materials as a roofing material, can be taken as 0.130 kN per meter cube. And the unit weight of stone masonry, it is taken as 24 kN per meter cube. So these are the some common values which are normally considered while calculating the total dead load of different materials which we frequently use by the designers. As I told you, for the live loads, we have to refer IS 875. Part 2, that is for the imposed load. Live loads are also termed as imposed loads. So those values have been specified clearly for the different categories depending on the use of the building, and those values we have to consider as a live loads during the design problems or design of the components. Then again, as specified by IS 456, some load combinations we have to consider whenever we are going to design the structural components or structure as a whole. So those load combinations are, we have to consider the dead load, then dead load plus imposed load, then dead load plus wind load, dead load plus earthquake load, dead load plus temperature loads, dead load plus imposed load plus wind load, dead load plus imposed load plus earthquake load, dead load plus imposed load plus temperature loads, dead load plus wind load plus temperature load, dead load plus earthquake load plus temperature load, dead load plus imposed load plus wind load plus temperature loads, and last is dead load plus imposed load plus earthquake load plus temperature load. So just as I told you that the meanings of DL is dead load, WL is wind load, EL is temperature load, IL is imposed load, EL is earthquake load. So one note is given in IS 456 that when snow load is present on the roofs, that we have to replace the imposed load by snow load in the above combinations. Means that whenever you have to consider the snow load, so instead of considering the imposed load, you have to consider the snow load. Just for example, if you consider the second combination, and if you are calculating or if you are going to consider the snow load, then that combination shall be taken as dead load plus snow load. So this is about the loads and the load combination. We stop here. In next lecture, we'll discuss about the characteristic loads. Thank you.